Our top story at this hour, mourners in Edinburgh will get the first chance to pay their respects before the coffin of Queen Elizabeth II as it lies at the St. Giles Cathedral in the Scottish capital. On Monday, King Charles III will mount a vigil in honor of his mother. Thousands are expected to line up to see the flag-draped casket of the late monarch, which arrived at the Holyrood place. Make that palace on Sunday after a six-hour journey from Balmoral Castle. Unlike other world leaders, British monarchs die in office, meaning their funerals have been carefully planned in advance. The original funeral plan for Queen Elizabeth II was codenamed Operation London Bridge. But since she died in Scotland, her death set in motion the so-called Operation Unicorn. It was named after Scotland's national animal, which also forms a part of the Royal Coat of Arms. Now, here's a quick rundown of what will happen in the next few days. Today, Monday, the King and Queen concert will travel to Edinburgh to join a procession to St. Giles Cathedral. On Tuesday, the Queen's only daughter, Princess Anne, will accompany her coffin as it is flown back to London. A rehearsal for a procession from Buckingham Palace to Westminster will also take place. On September 14, the Queen's coffin will be taken to the Westminster Palace in a gun carriage procession. She will lie in state there until the morning of her funeral. Millions of mourners, as well as world leaders, will get a chance to pay their final respects. The Queen's state funeral will then take place at Westminster Abbey in central London. The service will be televised and 2 minutes of silence will be held across the UK. After the funeral, the Queen's coffin will travel in procession to Windsor. A graveside service will be held at Windsor Chapel before the Queen's burial. Charles III was formally proclaimed the new king on Saturday in a ceremony that was televised for the first time. Meanwhile, over at Windsor Castle, a show of unity among the king's children. Our Europe News Bureau chief, Rose Eklarinal, tells us more.
I now call on the clerk of the council.
In the centuries-old tradition of proclaiming a sovereign, His Majesty King Charles III was proclaimed at the Accession Council at St. James's Palace in London. The first part was attended by privy councillors without the king present. Here, the king was proclaimed the sovereign and the council approved consequential orders. The second part was the king's first privy council, where he made his declaration, read and signed oath. The principal proclamation followed at the palace's balcony, read by Garter King of Arms. This was the first public reading of the declaration, which was repeated in Wales, Northern Ireland and Scotland.
God save the king!
From now on, the national anthem will be God Save the King, reverting to the wording sung 70 years ago. Outside St. James's Palace, Filipinos also lined up to see the newly proclaimed king.
God Save the Queen. Before, now it's God Save the King. It's really nice. Okay. I mean, really, really nice. It's so sad. I am sad. The Queen left us. But welcome to the King. Okay. All the best to the King.
Because I've been here matagal na. So, para bang yung queen sa akin ni mother, yeah, a grandmother as well.
We're just hoping na magiging okay yung bagong king. And itutuloy niya kung ano man yung naging legacy ng mother.
In Balmoral, after attending a private church service, Princess Anne, Prince Andrew, Prince Edward and their families have been viewing tributes and meeting well-wishers who left flowers for the Queen. In Windsor, the official residence of the Queen before her death, the new Prince and Princess of Wales, William and Kate, surprised crowds paying tribute to the Queen as they were joined by Harry and Meghan outside Windsor Castle. A palace spokesperson has said, the Prince of Wales invited the Duke and Duchess of Sussex to join him and Princess of Wales to greet well-wishers outside the palace. The Queen's funeral is set on September 19th, and it is also declared a bank holiday. With Joffre Tacardon, Rose Eklarinal, ABS-CBN News, London.